Welcome back. And let's go ahead, start off with what our current visibility is around the area. We have a few more of our heartland cities starting to deal with denser and denser fog. Centerville now down to 8 miles of visibility, 1 mile of visibility in and around Kirksville. And I mean, what we saw on that Skycam really, really illustrating how foggy it is out there. Elsewhere, we're seeing some denser fog building in just southeast of Edina as well. A big reason behind it is how warm the air is near the surface. Warmer air over a cooler ground creates some evaporating moisture that, with very, very light winds right now, doesn't get the chance to dissipate out, doesn't get blown out of the area. So that's why we're holding on to some of those foggy conditions, as well as the light rain that is moving into the area as well. Taking a look out towards Kansas City and St. Joseph, though, this is going to continue to slide up towards the northeast, impacting the area as we get in towards these later morning and through the afternoon hours as well. Temperatures right now, not much of a difference from where we were at just about half an hour ago. 32 degrees still in Centerville, 33 in Unionville, 37 in Keosauqua, and 35 down in Macon. So a lot of our areas dealing with light misting rain, and a big reason behind that is a large area of moisture. A lot of that thanks to this warm front accompanying low pressure system building its way off towards our northeast. That's going to be the catalyst for the severe storms well out towards the east and towards Tennessee and the Ohio River Valley as well. But for us, what it's going to do is just help bring in a little bit extra moisture to the area. But what we're going to see later on is cold air on the backside. Actually, down here towards our south is a cold front on the backside of that low pressure system. That's going to be a big catalyst for a cool down that will help bring in some of these snow as well as wintry mix chances. But overall, don't expect to see much accumulating in the term of winter precip. Later on, heading in towards the evening hours, high pressure is going to build well off towards our north and west, and that's going to help clear these clouds out as we head in towards Wednesday morning. But a chilly, chilly start to the day, and overall, Wednesday is not going to feel that great as sunny skies and temperatures only in towards the low 40s and upper 30s. Our next round of precipitation is going to be, once again, low pressure and a warm front that works its way towards the area, helping spawn some lighter showers late Thursday afternoon in towards the early evening hours. And then snow returns on the backside of a cold front that will be very similar to what we just saw over Easter. It's going to be impacting a lot of just our northeast Missouri areas as it works its way through in a more southeasterly direction. High pressure back in towards Saturday, and we clear everything out for a sunnier start to the weekend. But we will see precipitation returning, ending the weekend. How much can you expect in terms of rainfall amounts? Maybe just another 1/10 of an inch or so. Not a lot looking to work its way through. Very light, just some misting. As for snowfall amounts, we could see some higher amounts in areas like Albia, Centerville, Unionville, where we have the cooler temperatures pushing in first. But overall, we are going to be looking for some lowered snowfall and winter precip amounts. As for your extended forecast, we're looking for our warmest day of the week on Thursday. Now stick with us. Tech Bites is coming up next.